Okay. So I would love to just find out if you guys here, how many of you feel like you have some type of a brand on social media and that you are kind of clear on when you post, what to post because you're on brand. I just want to see how many of you are there. There is no right or wrong. Just want to find out where you guys are. So say yes. If you're feeling pretty confident on your brand, put it in the chat. Give me a yes. If you don't, say no. Just say no. No. I'm gonna see how many. So Janice, no. Lori, no. Brenda, yes. Mai, no. Irene, no. Sherry is a maybe. Okay. Awesome. Anybody else? Okay, great. So Stacy's getting there. Awesome. Renee, not really. Big no. Okay, awesome. So yay, that's why you're here. And listen, guys, Melissa and I, we've been doing lots of deep diving, taking lots of social media courses and stuff. And this isn't going to happen overnight. Today's goal for all of you is to start thinking about your brand if you don't have one, or if you do have a brand, to start thinking about maybe how you tweak it so that it's even more effective online. Okay, so that is what our goal is going to be over the next 2 hours. If we have time near the end, we might be able to do some breakout, but we do have 9 steps that we're going to teach you. 9 steps. There actually is a workbook. I'm going to take you through the workbook that we used in the GoPro. And you guys will have access to it so that you can go back. And trust me, you will be going back to the workbook. This is an organic process that you will be able to go back to and tweak and play. Okay. And so I just want to say give yourself some grace and some compassion. Please don't beat yourself up if you're seeing and comparing. Yourself to other people that they feel like you feel like you're so far behind is like just be okay where you're at today and know that we're doing this to help you sharpen your pencil so that over time it's going to get easier and easier and easier. Okay. So I just want to give you that. Melissa, did you want to add anything to that? I don't know if she's there. I know that she. Okay. So. I have a little mini presentation, and I'm kind of actually going to show you where I want you to end, where you, and then we're going to roll back to the start. Melissa, I was just saying, is there anything else that you wanted to add in regards to just opening up this workshop?
No, I think you sort of cut where we are, where we're going, and give yourself grace.
Okay, awesome. Yes. Okay. And actually, you know what I want to do? I want to do an exercise for you guys. It's going to take a minute. I want all of us to be in coherence. And you're like, what is coherence? Coherence is the quickest way for you to get into a place of love, gratitude, joy, happiness, excitement. Okay. The opposite to that is being an incoherence, a fear, anxiety, a stress, a frustration of thoughts of I can't do this. I can't, this is so overwhelming. I don't see myself there. We don't want you to be in incoherence through this 2-hour workshop. I want you to be in coherence so that you can be in a zone of genius. And I'm going to teach you how to do that. Who's up for that? 1 minute. I'm going to show you guys how to get into coherence. This will be a tool that will help you move forward in life in much more ease and joy. Does that sound good? Okay, so I'm gonna walk you through an exercise. So get comfortable. I want everybody to close your eyes. And I want you to just be connected to your body. How does it feel in the chair? Does it feel heavy? Does it feel light? And I want you to take your right hand and I want you to put it on your heart. And I want you to put your left hand and I want to put it just around your belly. Get connected to that body. And we're going to start doing some 3 deep breaths together. We're going to start with breath number one. And I want you to do a deep breath through your nose and an exhale through your mouth. And we're going to do it together. So breath one. Exhale. Breath two. Exhale. Breath three. Exhale. Now I want you to think of a favorite place that brings you joy and happiness. Was it a holiday you went on with your family? Is it the cottage? Is it the beach? And I want you to go there right now. Go to your favorite place in the world. And I want you to listen to the sounds. I want you to feel the air. You're outside. Ask yourself if you're there by yourself or with the people that you love. And I just want you to go there and keep on deep breathing. And I want you to just to be there right now of how you feel. How do you feel at your happy place? And hold that place for the next 15 seconds. Open up your eyes. Congratulations, you just ended up entering a world of coherence. How do you guys feel? Much better? Grounded? Balanced? Awesome. Okay. Learn to start your day every day like that. And when you feel stress and anxiety or you can't do it, just give yourself a minute to get back into coherence, because there's only two states that you can be in. And if you choose coherence more than incoherence, you're going to have a really happy, awesome, joyful life. Okay, peace. Awesome. So I'm going to share a screen here. Okay, and slideshow from beginning. Okay, so we're going to talk about building your brand on social media today. And so I'm actually going to show you some examples of the idea of what it will look like to be on brand. Okay. So I'm actually going to show you some examples. This is obviously, I'm actually going to show you Facebook, and Melissa Hyde is going to show you some examples on Instagram about having a clear branding. So if you can see, here, this woman, Julie, make sure we're putting people on mute. Julie is, she helps moms find a new level of energy. And she's got three of her kind of superpowers. Do you see how she's got she's an unschooling mom. So I'm thinking that means homeschooling. She's a intuitive business and health coach. And she's a gratitude guru. And click here for a gratitude meditation. And there she is. So let me see if I can move this here. You guys can see on her, bio, on a mission to help moms to find a new level of energy, follow me. So you can put in the chat right now, when you see that, do you know what she does? Do you know what she feels? Do you like it? Are you drawn to her? Do you like the colors? Is her branding on par? Okay, do you see, let me just see what you guys are saying about this. I love doing this with me and my kids. I love her. Yeah, there you go. Love her branding and so much energy. Okay, so that's an example of somebody showing energy. Okay, next one here. This is Simone. She's a truth seeker, seeking mother, a visionary, an inspirational speaker on a mission to help you manifest your dreams. If not now, when? If not you, who? Global entrepreneur, coach, and inspirational speaker, embracing you to reach your life dreams. Follow me. So that we're going to teach you this formulation that you're going to see over and over and over again. Last night on the team call, we were teaching you about getting a really good photo for your profile, but then also getting a really good photo for you again. They call it a billboard. So when you see this background Facebook cover. You might hear me say billboard. That's what I mean by billboard. That's your billboard. And the cool thing is you can change your billboard over and over and over again and tweak it, especially if you've got promotions coming up. You can change that billboard. It's the biggest untapped area where people are missing to brand themselves on social media. Here's another one. I love this one. This is Steve, and Steve is on a mission to conquer cancer. He is a cancer thriver and understands what it's like to manage life during and after cancer. Feel better by understanding what your body needs. Love, laugh, thrive. And then it shows here, he's a cancer thriver and a gut health coach. Click here. I love his colors. I love his energy. It's clear on what he does. And then right here, he has conquer brain fog with food. And then he has his link bio. Angel, on a mission to help women and their families by building confidence and financial freedom. She's an entrepreneur. She's a coach and motivator. She's a world-class mom. And she actually has her link tree right in the top of her billboard. Follow me. Are you seeing a theme? Danelle, Caribbean mamapreneur, helping women and men go from having an employee mindset to a boss mindset. Team builder, human motivator, world-class mom. Linktree, follow me. You guys getting a little bit of the theme that's going on here? This is where we want you to get to. It probably won't happen today, but we are going to give you 9 simple steps to help you get here. Here's another one, helping women to gain self-confidence and take charge of their life by working from home without disturbing their motherhood and family commitments. Wife and mom, business coach, and fitness specialist. Tamara, on a mission helping people to tap into their beauty and health from within. There is her link tree. And then she has a little bit more about what she's about. This one I pulled out. I pulled this one out because this isn't my favorite. And I'll tell you why it's not my favorite, because as you've seen the other ones before, the other ones were a lot more clear. I don't like the way that his billboard shows up, like let's connect, but I don't really know what he is doing. So this is an example of one that doesn't get me excited because I really don't know what he's doing. Peter Fox, this was a good one. I like this one. He's a speaker, motivator, lifestyle coach, teaching entrepreneur, and he has his mission statement, helping you unleash the best version of yourself and create you a better life. And here's another one too. Top leader and coach, ready to play full out, let's connect, Linktree. And then again, both pictures. You see a profile picture and then a different picture, and then a little bit clear of her mission and what she does. So I could go on and on and on and on to show you lots of examples, but I just wanted to give you a teaser of where we want you to go, of where we want you to go eventually. It doesn't have to happen tomorrow. And then the other thing I just wanted to show you on that one here, hold on, is, and Melissa, are you just about ready to go for your piece? I'm just going to show you mine, guys, because if you haven't seen mine, this is what I'm working on. I haven't perfected mine yet. I'm still working on it, but I'm going to show you what I did through the GoPro. So I did this through the GoPro accelerator because they gave us homework. So I did this one on my own. So you guys can see that, Nicole Scott, inspiring women to live their best life. And then I have my 3 things, but you can see already that it's not Facebook friendly because I did this on my own. I did this on Canva. So you can't see that I'm an author. So you actually don't see my because the edit cover profile is there. You might be able to see it, but I can't. And then I have like, they say some type of call to action. So I have here, need to shred some unhealthy habits, DM me. So some people have follow me, some people, you know, for my free guide, you know, to join our healthy starts, you know, challenge or whatever that is. So I'm working on mine. It isn't exactly where I want it, but I was open to the coaching. I was open to the homework. I was open to like, let's try it out. And I did this one on my own, guys. And I've never done anything like this before. So my learning curve was like this. So when you guys think that, oh, Nicole's got somebody paid to do this. No, this was all me trying to figure this stuff out. Okay. So I just wanted to show you that one. Okay. So that's where we want to take you today. I hope you guys are, oh, good. So Lori says she can see author. I just can't see it. Okay. Pretty specific, clear, simple, and lovely. Brands on par. Yeah. Awesome. Melissa, did you want to share Instagram? We're going to show you some examples of clear branding on Instagram now.
Sure. I just want to interrupt this regularly scheduled program to share some news because we're all going to be on here. At noon, Stephen Millman is going on the Juice Plus Partners page to do prize giveaways of money and Vitamixes. And I'll let you guys know, as of Monday, Tower Garden lights are back in stock for ordering. So you heard it here first, and just letting you know, because you're going to be with us and you won't be there, but go there after. Make sure you are a member of that, the Juice Plus Partners page, and he goes there live often and you can get all the updates. So I just wanted to share that with you guys. It's pretty exciting. All right. Have you given me the power to share my screen, Nicole?
You got the power today, girl.
That's Canada. They're going to be back for
yes.
order.
Yes, 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 yes.
Best news ever.
So here we are, starting with our fearless leader. These are just screenshots of Instagram. As you can see, Instagram's a little different than Facebook. It doesn't have, as what Nicole calls that, billboard. So you still want to have that photo of just you. As beautiful as your children are, as cute as your dog are, do not put them in there. This is about you. People are following you, and you can share all those great things in your life, in your story and so on, but your photo needs to be exactly that, your photo. And we're going to show you a cool app. We talked about it last night. I'll probably touch on it again today to make your photo stand out. And then you want to be really clear to the average person so that they understand exactly what you are about and what do they have to offer you. So it's pretty straightforward here. The category that she's in is health and beauty. It's about healthy lifestyle and nutrition hacks. I help women raise their energy. Wow, totally makes sense. So if I can even get through a day without a nap at 3 o'clock, I'm going to reach and say, okay, what is your hack? Tell me how I can have more energy. And then also, because she has one page, she's putting it here so people can follow her there. Gray hair. Oh yeah. I'm starting to get these things going on. What's that about? I want to see what it's about. And then a link tree. And this is so important, A, for you to have a place with all your links. But then when you are talking on social media, it's so easy. All you have to say is go to the link in my bio there, and you can order our cleat, whatever it is you're saying, and always directing people there, so you get people used to going there, because most people like to order on their own, right? So get them used to going there, and then you'll have all the stuff there. So super important. And then I forget what these are called. What are these circles down here called? Having a mind block, what these are called. But anyways, you want to start filling in those things. We're not going to talk about that today. Don't even worry about those right now. Mm-hmm. But eventually we'll get into that. Okay, so right. There's that.
Irene
one.
Just said they're called highlights.
Oh, thank you. Mind block. So here is Boss Lee, one of the highest paid network marketers on the planet. And I just want to say to like, follow her if you don't already. And even if you don't like someone's style, and I'll be honest, I don't like Jesse Lee's style. And it's not a slant at her. It's just, it doesn't resonate with me, but she's freaking brilliant. So follow these people and watch what they're doing and copy those things and make them your own, right? So the style might not be, but you can always learn from these people. So here, entrepreneur, top leader and coach, I'll help you. So I'm a network marketer. Okay, maybe this girl can help me. Global leader, 200 million more in sales, insane. And then finally, turn on notifications, like she tells you exactly what you need to do. And there again, shop on the link in the bio right there. So whatever she's promoting, you know where you can go to get it. Lauren, I'm sure a lot of you know her. She is one of the top in Juice Plus. And this is her. So she's a public speaker and best-selling author because she does do Juice Plus, of course, but her primary thing is a speaker. She's like Tony Robbins' right hand, doing all of his events. She runs them as well. So then she's retreats. So there you have it. Register my retreat. She's got the link there. Pretty clear of what she does. I think I have one more. And then Kelly, who again, most of you should know, she is on our team in Arizona. And she, and what does she do? Plant-based recipes and nutrition tips. Talk about specific. That's exactly what she offers. Help women look and feel their best. And she's a recipe ebook author. And then the link tree, it's there over and over again. So see the theme there, the link tree? I think, yeah, that's it. Just to show you a few.
Right. Okay, so what do you guys think of that? Is that, is that clear? Do you guys kind of see the vision of where we want to take you? And I don't want you guys to get intimidated by the fact that you see some people that are calling themselves coaches, or they're calling themselves dietitians or nutritionists or whatever. There are so many people that aren't in that realm that still get creative with their name. And that's what we're going to work on that today, is if you're like, well, I don't have any, you know, thing behind my title, that is okay. That is really okay. It's about coming up with some really catchy names that you can, you know, grab people. And Irene, you're starting to see the pattern. And Janice, you're clear. And Sherry Dokes, yes, we are coaches in our program and business. Exactly. Exactly. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pull up. Give me one sec here. I have this all open in my poor calendar. The computer has, I think, way too many things open right now, but give me a sec and I will get there to find out where I pulled it up. And Melissa, maybe you can chat for 1 or 2 seconds while I pull up the document that I had opened earlier.
Sure. What did you want me to talk about?
Yep. So just maybe this is your opportunity to talk a little bit about the why. Why.
That's what I was going to go with.
Thanks.
So once you know why you're doing this business, the rest of it honestly is going to come so easy. The posting on social media, because you'll know who you're talking to and how you can help them. So sometimes it's easier to figure out what you're not, groups that you do not want to focus on. So for example, for me, I'm focusing on women more my age, that their kids are now independent. I used to say that don't live at home, but they seem to have all moved back home now because of this pandemic, but they're independent. So I'm not driving them around. So I don't often talk about the children's health study on my social media, because that's not the age that I am gearing towards. And I know other coaches have coached other people on our team even and said, oh, you don't want to limit yourself. You want to, you know, because then you'll limit your orders. And I actually totally disagree with that. I think if you can decide on who your niche is and really get to know them, what are they all about? What are their pains? What are their problems? And you know what we have provides a solution. Your message is going to land on them. They are going to hear you and feel like, oh my God, she's talking to me. She's just like me. Oh my gosh, yes. So many kids at home going crazy, et cetera, et cetera. So everything I do is geared to somebody like that. So I'm just talking their own language. Having said that, our product still does appeal to every single person on the planet. Everyone needs our product. Everyone will benefit. So you're not limiting yourself, but you're going to reach your mark and much better success. And I've seen that happen over and over again when people narrow down as to who they're talking to. Brandy?
Sarah, Crystal, and I did a social media training. And one of the things that she had us do was write down things that we do not like and things that we do like. So like we do not like negativity, and, you know, write all of those things down. And then beside it, write all the things that we do like, so that we can know the difference of the people that we're drawing in. And the other thing was that we have pillars. So in our business, because we have so much going on, we actually have more pillars, but I think ours were lifestyle, So how you want to live, things that you want to do in your life, like travel and, you know, little points like that. And then we had health. And so with our program, our own story around health, whatever that is. So like creating micro stories under all of these pillars. And then when you write them all down, the other one for us was, I think, like spiritual and maybe mindfulness, and write down all of the things that we do in there, like audiobooks, books, you know, things that we do to grow ourselves. And then you pick from these micro stories and you use that as content to speak to every single time. But it's really around yourself and the things you're interested in. And then when you want to know more about it, you just search it.
Yeah, definitely. That's, we'll just get there later, getting really specific. So just starting talking about just who you want to serve. Like everyone on this team wants to help people. Awesome. But who do you want to help? Why do you want to help? And that's what's so important. Once you know that, as I said, that's when your social media becomes easy. Like let's use Nicole as an example, the Gorgeous Gray Movement. That's so specific to people that are transitioning to gray. Maybe they already have gone gray, but they have something to do with going gray. So her content is so easy for her to come up, if you will, because she is living that. That is what she is passionate about. And she understands the challenges, the fears, the excitement, whatever it might be of that. And that's where we want you guys to figure out is what is your niche? Who is it that you want to help and why do you want to help them? And then the rest, honestly, is so much easier once you know that, as opposed to just throwing at the wall and seeing what sticks. Awesome. Turn it back to you, Nicole.
Yeah. And Brandy, that is so perfect because exactly what you were saying is part of our 9 steps. So that's a nice prelude into what we're going to kind of, you know, move through today. So that's awesome. And to know that you've already got some great training from some probably rockstar social media experts. So that's awesome. So you guys, I will give you this booklet. I will have it available. But in the meantime, what you can do if you want is just to screenshot the 9 steps. And I'm just going to keep on going through, but I will give you access to this as well. So today is about social media branding and social media. And I think you guys will all agree is changing the way we communicate and the way we are perceived both positively and negatively. And every time you post a photo or update your status, you are contributing to your own digital footprint and personal brand. Everybody is branding themselves, but not everybody has a personal brand. So your social media presence speaks to who you are and the audience that you are reaching. So the first exercise is we want to help you create your unique personal brand. And the step one is modeling the best. So this is going to be fun. This is going to be like, this is the workshop that we're going to have you guys do. So before you start to create your own unique brand, you need to select 2 to 3 people who have a great online presence. Start with Facebook. If you know them because of business, they are most likely on LinkedIn. Check their YouTube videos. Study what they have done to build their brand. What set them apart that made you take notice? And write down what you've noticed. How was their presence? Is it very casual? Is it mostly professional, more leisurely? What are they wearing to depict this image? What message do they convey in social media? Is it about their lifestyle? Is it about their business, their family? Take a few minutes now and write down what you have observed about them and be sure to include how you feel when you see them online. So I'm going to give you guys the next 10 minutes. I'm going to actually put you guys on a timer. 10 minutes, and I want you to do this exercise right now. I want you to take some time and find 1, 2, or 3 people online and ask these questions. And I'm going to get one of you to share your experience of who you found and what stood out for you. So I'm going to maybe put some music on, and we're going to listen to some music right now and go from there. Does that sound good? And I would, let me see here. Let me get the music going first. I don't think I can run both. I don't know if I can do music and share screen.
We'll just put it on your phone and have it play quietly in the background. Would that work?
No, not when you're sharing on Zoom, but let me see. Can you hear that?
Just have your ear. No.
Okay, hold on. Can you hear that? Could you hear that music? No.
No.
Oh, let me know. Can you hear that?
I should have left a couple tears ago. And even when I'm with you, I still feel alone. Got me down on my knees. Heart is froze, I don't feel nothing. Drinking and drugs just to feel something.
Take a chance. close to the one, I'm in a different mode. It's my life, do what I want, I be with different. You know the pick and roll, I picked her up and sent her home. I got rich, I strong, we get them in and get them gone. You know Trappy just got out, ain't have to put them on. We the ones who got the numbers to put the city on. It's the middle of the summer, I got a hoodie on. My demon time ain't nothing nice, I try not to wear nothing twice. I came up off of shooting dice, yeah. My little brother ain't living right, my sister them doing alright. My cousin them still serving life, yeah. Seen the robber rob a dig, and I seen the preacher get caught for cheating. I break the bank for one of my peeps. I said I'm the one they didn't believe. I show them the facts, now they all need me. I'ma get cake as long as I'm breathing. They making it hard, it's really easy, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'ma turn up on a hater every chance that I get. I want the biggest watcher they got, don't care if they kill every my wrist. All these gunners, all I wish I would claim that. They get hard when they get guns, we got a hood full of sticks. Soon as they say we can't come, you know we'll run around that. You can miss me with that mix, you know I live in the mix. Money, cars, and clothes, you know I live in the mix. Money, cars, and clothes, yeah. She think I'm a regular rapper, I'm not. One person come tell me we tell you block. Watch me run it to the tip of this.
Okay, I am going to make sure that we are, there we go. Okay, we're going to stop there and we are going to talk about this exercise. Who is willing to volunteer to talk about the one person that you found that is ready to go? Any hands up? Give me hands up. I can't see, but Brandy.
Nicole, before you start, I just wanted to say that I'm searching through 700 people that I'm following on Facebook and I can not even find one that follows the billboard and the descriptions that you're describing. So obviously it is not out there yet.
You get to stand out among your 700 people, which is kind of cool, right? Yeah, there's not a lot. I was actually scrolling and I came up with the same thing, Renee. Is I go right away and I don't know much about them. There's no bio, there's no, you know, they're not business people. Like the first thing that I see is they're not in business, right? They're not in business. They're not selling anything. They're not doing anything like in that regard. It's just like a fun profile pitch of their friends and family. So yeah, I think I saw, yeah. And Sherry said, yeah, I'm not finding any as well. Exactly. Not a lot of people showing us that they're in business. Brandy, do you want to just open up and tell us a little bit about what you found?
So I followed them on Instagram and on Facebook. And so the two platforms look a little bit different. On Facebook, there really is no bio and there's no description of what they're doing. But on Instagram, there is. And so I just have like some of the top leaders in our business that I'm following. So one is Kira, and she has her bio. It's very business. It's very lifestyle oriented. She does obviously a lot of cooking because she is a chef.
Can you type her name right now in the chat so people can all go in there and grab her so they can at least use an example? I think that'll be great. Her first and last name. And you're going through her Facebook profile right now.
Yeah, so you'll find her on Instagram is where I am right now.
You're on Insta?
Her on Instagram as I am Kira Love.
How do you spell Kira?
K-I-R-A.
Beautiful, simple. Okay, I am Kira, okay?
Yes, and so she does have her bio and she does have a link tree. And a lot, she is of course so huge. Her Instagram is going to look a little bit different than, you know, maybe what ours does, because she does a lot of interviews and stuff like that. Everything looks very professional. They have people that are paid to do all of this work for them. So it's going to be hard to really emulate this specifically, but I like her images. I like how everything just looks like fun and casual. And the other one that I follow is Shani Thompson. So hers is Shani Peach.
How do you spell that?
Putting it in the chat.
Okay, beautiful.
And for her, she's also Australian. So everything over there, the lifestyle is just so much different than ours, right? It's a lot of beach life and, you know, they have warm weather 24/7 all year round. But she shares a lot of lifestyle, business. She's funny. She does like little funny reels. And she does share a lot of like what she's into. She's into like manifesting and abundance and all of those things. And just as I'm looking at hers, another person who might be more relatable to follow is Carrie Conway. From, yeah, she's just in people that she follows. It's the Carrie Conway.
Carrie's with a K.
K-E-R-R-Y. Oh, it's Karen Way. C-A-R-O-N-W-A-Y.
Okay, the Karen Way. Okay, so check that out. Yeah, I'm doing that right now. Okay, so the Karen Way.
Yeah, okay, thanks for typing it. No, that's not right.
I think, is it? That's not right?
I'll type it.
Okay. Oh, there you go. The Carrie. So that's E-R-Y. And then
she's one of the NMDs in Synergy.
Oh, there we go. Okay, got it. The Carrie Karen Way.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. So there you go.
So she might be somebody who could be a little bit more relatable to our environment if you have, you know, kids. She shares a lot of kid pictures. She does a lot of product posting for ideas. I do follow her, but not all that much. And then the other person that I do follow is Katie Wren. And she is like relatable in a lot of posts, but she's also, you know, one of the biggest leaders in the company. So some things are things that you can aspire to. But her posting, you know, is pretty normal. Like she'll just talk about her shake. She'll talk about her kid. She'll talk about the business. And she's just a really like down to earth, normal person that you can kind of follow and get ideas from as well. And so for her, yes, hers very like leisure, casual lifestyle, business, family. She does have small kid. But those are all the people that I follow among other ones in their teams. And then whenever, like I watch Brian Marsh and whenever they do a promotion, I start to follow the person that promoted as ideas too. But in their Facebook, I'm not seeing, you know, this kind of stuff that you're trying to show us for the bios and stuff.
Right. Awesome. Now, my mom said, are there any mature women for me to follow? So I would say that, yes, I just haven't searched them. But one of the things I thought about for you, mom, as we're working on your brand, I just actually went onto Instagram and put healthy grandma, healthy granny. And actually, there's quite a few like hashtags around that. So within that community, I bet you could find some examples and you and I can work a little bit more. But it's branding yourself so that you're kind of narrow focus and we're going to get there. But thank you for sharing that, Brandy. I hope you guys found that somewhat helpful, is like finding the people to start to follow to see their brand. If you want to follow some of the big ones like Fraser Brooks, if you go to Facebook, Fraser, and I'm going to just spell it for you so you can find him, Fraser. So I'm going to spell it for you. I like following him. He's hilarious. I mean, I'm trying to get to the chat button. Can you spell it out, Melissa, in the chat? F-R-A-Z-E-R, Fraser, and then Brooks, B-R-O-O-K-E-S, Fraser Brooks. Just, yeah. So that's another person that I follow. I just wrote down what I like about Fraser is he uses bright colors. I love his signature smile. He's like almost like a goofball. I love the energy that shows up. He's always changing his billboard all the time based on his programs and stuff. And he just has a really clear brand of what he does. So that's another example. So that's step one. Do you guys have any questions or comments as we move to step two? This is just giving you guys examples and visions of what could be possible with your brand. Any comments or questions? Harry Fox says she loves Charlene Johnson and Jesse Lee, and I love Fraser Brooks as well. Awesome. So these are some great examples for people to follow. Okay, so we're going to move on to step two. Step two now is, what do you love? What are you passionate about? What are your interests? This is what Brandy was talking about. You attract people by your actual passions. The secret sauce is talking about your passions and attracting like-minded people. Then you can convert those people into prospects in an elegant way that doesn't offend. Write down what really drives you. What's your passion about what you love? I'm going to give you guys 3 minutes. 3 minutes. So at 11:53, we will come back here. So start to write down what are you passionate about.
Yeah. Keep going. Call my kids and Givenchy. She must think 1 + 1 = 3. Charge us before the streets. I would nod and nod. They woke up a beast. Struggle with maybe we used to have water for dinner. We didn't have nothing to eat. Soon as I get on this, they gon' look on me bad. I'm like, damn, he was with me. I'm a turn from a hater every chance that I get. I want the biggest watcher they got. I don't care if they can hurt my wrist. All these. All I wish I would claim that they get hard when they get guns. We got a hood full of sticks. Soon as they say we can't come, you know we'll run around that. You can miss me with that bitch. You know I live in the mix. Money, cars, and clothes. You know I live in the mix. Money, cars, and clothes.
I'm from the trench. Be tucked on the net, but really be there for attention. They be talking like they really rich, but really be begging me under my pitch. I give a 40-50,000 cash and start up a business. I spend a hell at the dentist. I'd rather fucking pay up a rent for a year just to get out of her feelings. I'm in a Lambo truck in my hood, nobody gon' tell me. Going to Cali, I pick my weed for sure, nobody gon' mail me. Dice gang, crap's a CeeLo, I need cash, don't sell me. Baby got his hood, I'm smashing, you can tell they really rich. Drop the low, ain't no room right now, I took her to the O. Then I put up on the lamp, cause she a fan of Booney Mo. I got the city on lock, f***ing up all the ops. I be around with $3 million in jewelry, I'm standing on all the blocks. This an anthem, dropping a 6 in the Phantom, Black road truck with the all-white C-Street, mammy, I'm sitting on Panda, I love my cousin, she was a dancer. I love my brother, he was a scammer. Sit on my lap, cause I'm pulling her tracks, and I f*** from the back, cause she calling me handsome.
I'm a turn from a hater every chance that I get. I want the biggest watcher they got. Don't care if that can hurt my wrist. All these thumbs all I wish I would claim that. They get hard when they get guns. We got a hood full of sticks. Soon as they say we can't come, you know we'll run around that. You can miss me with that bitch. You know I live in the mix. Money, cars, and clothes. You know I live in the mix. Money, cars, and clothes.
We the best music.
Okay, so you guys have had about 3 minutes to write down some passions. Why don't you guys just drop in the chat, just share with us what are some of your passions. And I would love a volunteer, somebody that maybe hasn't spoken as an example, who can give us some shout outs of some passions. Mai, yes, go for it. What are some of your passions? What do you love?
I love to dance. I love making kombucha. I love being around the fire. I love ways to be cancer-free. Nature, the woods, beaches, oceans, organizing, freak, Mexico, mountains, oceans, sustainable ways, recycling, and wild edibles.
Awesome. Love it. One more person. Who else wants to share?
There's
Irene. Irene. Cool. What's that? Yeah, lots in the chat too. Okay, great. Irene, do you want to share?
So just run my list: health, nutrition, food, feel good, fitness, healthy living, family fun, community of like-minded people, balance, 80-20 rule, positivity, outdoors, hiking, biking, walking, the beach, the ocean, inspiring people to be happy, healthy, positive mindset. That was it.
Awesome. And I love you guys are putting in the chat, helping people live their best, healthiest, fullest life, loving food, cooking, baking, fitness, family, nature, friendship. Awesome. Okay. This is so fun. I love that you guys are, you're going to get to a place where you're going to be niching down here. So that was step two. We're going to move to step three. Ooh, this is going to be fun. Are you ready for this? What do you strongly disagree with? This is what Brandy was talking about. This flip side of knowing your passions is knowing what you disagree with, what you won't tolerate. It is what keeps you in integrity. Write down what you strongly disagree with. Okay. So I'm going to give you another 3 minutes on that one. Just go, just whatever comes to you.
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh. Second thing, second, don't you tell me what you think that I can be. I'm the one at the sail, I'm the master of my sea. Oh, ooh, the master of my sea. Oh, I was broken from a young age, taking my soak into the masses, writing my poems for the few that look at me, took to me, shook at me, feeling me, singing from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the...
Okay, so who wants to volunteer with what don't you like? Alona, can you share?
Yeah, I just wrote it in there. I just came up with like things that, you know, when I look at people's profile that I don't want to follow. So I said negativity, complaining, and not finding solutions, not being inclusive, being stuck up, not friendly or caring, and not compassionate.
Awesome. How about you, Lori?
So things that I don't tolerate are people that hold grudges, people that cheat, lie, being fake, being somebody you're not, and pleasing others at the risk of sacrificing your own happiness.
Right. Jen, you said putting on a show, fake salesy, being tied down to a job, not having grace, hate in speech, yeah, negativity, politics, complaining, blaming, criticizing, shaming, animal abuse, posing, belittling. Awesome. Okay, this is great. So this is what you like, what you don't like. So we're going to keep on going here. Yeah. There is a reason why we're going through these exercises, guys. Okay, so that was step three. Step four, your identity statement, who you are and who are you really? Now it's time to take a look at you. When you see yourself now, who are you? An entrepreneur, a friend, a spouse, a parent. These are your current roles. Now envision who you would really like to be when it comes to your online presence and who you really are or want to become. How you want others to perceive you. Don't hold back. Use objectives that depict an exciting, energetic, fulfilled you. Magnificent mompreneur, the MLM mentor, the lifestyle transformer. Take a few minutes to envision the real you, the one that is living a life of not only achievement, but fulfillment, who changes lives and is making a difference in the world. Take a few minutes to envision, who are you? After you lock in who you are, write an identity statement that states who you are, something that you will commit to saying daily as a ritual. So you get it in your body and it becomes who you truly are. It is a I am statement. Be sure to use language that is moving, emotional, and really drives in who you are and your mission. It is also a reflection of your values and what means most to you in your life. And here's an example. I'm a powerful, loving, giving champion of moms who radiates with energy, grace, and wisdom and transforms lives by leading others to create families of fulfillment and abundance. So I hope that's clear. This is your opportunity to start thinking about who you are. Some of you might come up with this statement today. Some of you may not. It might take you a while, but knowing what you like, knowing what you don't like, and seeing examples of other people on social media, this is your opportunity to start working on your identity statement, okay? Because once you start to really peel back the layers of who you are, it helps you get to your niche market and target who you're going to talk to. Any questions? Okay, great. I'm going to give you guys 10 minutes on this one because this is pretty important. I'm going to put some music on here. So 10 minutes, it's 12:02. We'll be back in 10 minutes. I'm going to put some music on.
You've heard has turned your spirit to
you
a dove.
Yeah,
your spirit up above.
And Nicole, it's really loud. I have my computer at like one, and then when you speak, I have to jack it up. So I don't know if anybody else agrees, but
okay.
Ashes to the ground, hoping my feelings they would drown.
Is that better?
Never did ever live, ebbing and flowing, inhibited.
Yeah, it's all super loud, but I just keep turning you down.
My volume is just about at zero on my computer too.
Oh, weird.
Oh, here.
It's really loud coming out this way.
Is that better?
Yeah.
Is that better?
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, thanks. Thank you for that. Thanks for the feedback.
The flames, you're the face of the future, the blood in my veins, oh, ooh, the blood in my veins, oh, ooh. But they never did ever live, ebbing and flowing, inhibited, limited, till it broke up when it rained down.
Nicole, do you mind putting it back on the other screen? Thanks.
Can you see that? Is that good there?
Yeah, keep going. Yeah, that's perfect.
Okay.
the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame. You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero. You could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people. Do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country. Do it for your name.
Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing.
But now, there's no limits to what I can do. See, life has no remorse, like trying to knock me off the course.
Okay, we are coming back to talk about this. And as you can see, this isn't an easy exercise. Who found it easy? Anybody find it easy? Who found it hard and challenging? Yeah, so you're gonna probably spend a lot of time here when you do homework beyond this. Yeah, extremely. Yeah, it's not easy, but I'm just wondering, is anybody gonna be brave enough to kind of share what they've come up with? And we're not judging you. It doesn't have to be perfect. As we say, it can be your shitty first draft. Mai?
I am an inspirational magnetic joypreneur, partner with women with big dreams. Together, we make monumental impact to transform our health and our bank accounts.
Love it. That's great.
Bam. Maybe you can write that in so people can screenshot it and give them some ideas. Love it. Love it. Love it. Anybody else want to share what you've come up with so far?
I'll share mine. It's not quite as powerful as Mai's. I am a real mom, energetic, creative, and scientific, who creates easy steps for families to climb for improved health, vibrance, and overall everyday living.
Okay.
Wicked. Yeah. Good job.
Yeah. Love it. Anybody else want to share?
Randy? Was this like our this was our personal mission statement?
Like your identity statement. It's who you are. Yeah.
Well, I wrote down something. So I'm a loving, compassionate mom. I bring fun and energy to every situation. I am abundantly giving and receiving. I think and grow rich and help. I didn't finish. And help other women to do the same. I didn't finish.
Yeah, that's okay. That's great. Great start. Love it. Anyone else want to share? Mom. Yeah.
I am an ever-transforming, loving, radiant, energetic, wisdom-filled seeker, community builder, and supporter to those who desire to take action through our community lifestyle support program.
Woohoo!
Very powerful. Maybe you can write that in as well and people can screenshot it. That's awesome.
Good job.
How's that feeling though? Do you see how it starts to get clear? Like when you know who you are and what you stand for, and as we start to niche down, you'll know what your content is going to be because you're going to keep on niching down based on what your values are, what you're passionate about, what you don't want. That's where we're going. Is this helpful so far? Give me some love. Give me a thumbs up. Are you learning? Lori's like, I'm loving it. Great. Awesome. Okay. We're going to keep on going. Thank you for your participation. And thank you for allowing us to do this work with you. Okay. So we are moving on to step five, which is how will you convey yourself and your identity? So social media is a very visual place. And when you did step one, what were the things you noticed in terms of physical presence? Now it's your turn. What would you do to create your identity and your brand? This is your time. It's all about you. Own it. This is who you are. So what will you wear? What colors would best depict who you are? What settings, backgrounds would you use? Will you have sound music in the background? Do you prefer natural settings or outdoor? Do you want impromptu images or something that is more filtered and staged? Think of all the elements in step one that had an impact or made an impression on you. Put on your favorite music, get in peak physical state, and let's do this. Start writing, see yourself, envision yourself. Who is the you that you would like the world to see you as? Okay, so I'm gonna give you 10 minutes here. And this is, and I'm going to leave the screen up. I'm going to go back and get some inspirational music on for 10 minutes, but I just want you to go to town. Just go to town and write down, how do you want to be perceived in the world on social media? Those are the questions to ask. Okay. Any questions? We're good. Okay. We are 12:16 and we will be back here in 10 minutes. Beautiful. I'm going to go find some music here. Thank you.
Can you go back to the screen, please?
I hope when you take that jump, you don't fear the fall. I hope when the water rises, you build a wall. I hope when the crowd screams out, screaming your name. I hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Whatever you wanna do, I'll be here right next to you. No matter what comes your way, I know it'll be okay. Whatever you wanna do, I'll be here right next to you. No matter what comes your way, I hope that you can say,
leave a shockwave like a superhero. Leave your crater in the sun. Lead a sandstorm out of the desert. Let the ocean surface boil. Be a rocket ship on your way to Mars. Be a race car ripping up the track. Live your life like it is all a dream. Always flying higher, don't look back. Go fast, go far, go wild. Fall down, stand up, go on. Go fast, go far, go wild. Till you drop, till you drop, till you drop. Go fast, go far, go wild. Fall down, stand up, go on. Go fast, go far, go wild. Till you drop, till you drop, till you drop. Leave your stand crowd like a rock star. Leave your firestorm in their heads. Cast a shadow like
ground shake with your steps. Be a speedboat on the open water. Be a jet plane cutting through the air. Claim your spot right in the Hall of Fame. And let all the haters swear. Go fast, go far, go wild. Fall down, stand up, go on. Go fast, go far, go wild. Till you drop, till you drop, till you drop. Show the whole universe you're around. Be the light in the dark for us to see. Become everything you dream to be.
Okay, we're going to stop there, and we are going to find out if anybody has done a little bit of work on this. Who wants to volunteer? Who wants to share? What did you come up with? This is helping you get kind of like your brand color, what you're going to wear, how you're going to show up. Anybody? Terry, yeah, I haven't heard from you in a while. It's lovely to see you. Terry's actually in the GoPro Accelerator in social media, so this is probably a nice refresher course for her.
Yeah, it's good to keep going over things to make it stick and to grow on it, right? So for me, I'm just answering the questions, right?
Yeah.
So I will wear something like this, where it's like casual or dressy casual, more casual than anything. Best colors for me that help me feel alive and radiant are greens and blues and some purple and white. Those are my colors. Background settings, I prefer nature and outside and beaches, but I also like to do the indoors and in anything indoor with my colors in the background kind of thing, and or the kitchen.
Yeah.
Which will, you know, is white. So that's great. Natural settings are preferred, but will likely showcase more indoors right now. I wanted to grow, I will growing with impromptu images, but for now I'm going to be starting more with a staged presence, whether it's in the kitchen or just doing a little TikTok live or something like that. My goal really is to be fun and educational, inspiring, happy, and vibrant. So that awesome. Is what I put.
Yeah. Great. And I if you guys follow Terry Fox, you can see that she changed her profile picture so it stands out, and mm-hmm. she used the Photo Room app. So congratulations on figuring it out and playing with it. That's awesome. Anybody else want to share?
I just want to make a comment about colors. So as we know, there's blue and there's 1,000 shades of blue. And pick the color that you like and then do some research on the meaning of that color, because you may find, oh, light blue doesn't actually resonate with what my message is. I like more of a royal blue, for example. Or you may not realize that, oh, I didn't realize the meaning of red is this. Okay, I want some red in my colors. So Google the meaning of colors, because it's really powerful as well. So you can even just change the shade of your color. You know what I mean? Or if you love the color, but maybe it's not your message, you could just have little splashes of it just because you love it. Chances are, though, if you love it, it makes you feel good, it's going to work with you. But it's a great exercise to do. And then you can get really specific, you know, like on paint, it has a certain number. You can find out what that number is and then use that in your social media so that you're getting the exact blue every single time.
Awesome. I love it. Do you guys know what Melissa's color is? Any guesses? What's her color? Red. What'd you say? Red.
Red.
Red. What's my color? Mm-hmm. Melissa's is red. What's my color?
Ready orange, actually.
Ready orange, yeah. Mom said pink.
Mm-hmm. Pink. Yeah.
I'm blue.
Yeah.
What do I have back there? My new pink, my new pink flowers to represent my color. I see, I'm tweaking it. This is new. Just adding that like splash of color so people will think, Hank and Nicole, what did I do? I got new computer glasses. What color are they? Pink, right? What color is my mom?
Purple.
Purple. Purple. Do you see how a color can symbolize your brand? Mm-hmm. My mom has had a brand for a very long time, since her 50s, mm-hmm. and she's throwing purple in. This is who I am. What does color in her hair represent, guys? When you see a woman with gray in her 60s and you see color in her hair, what does that showcase to you?
Fun.
Fun. Playful.
Brave. Openness.
What's that?
Openness.
Openness. Willing to stand out in the crowd. Mom, how often do people stop you about your purple hair?
That's the thing I get the most comments on. Yeah, but I have to say, like, colors, like, I need bright yellow. I have a picture and I have a purple scarf that you brought me back with the butterflies.
Yeah.
And that's my most favorite picture because I have purple. The yellow, because it's bringing in the lower and the upper energies.
Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, thanks.
Awesome. And even just the simplicity, guys, of your branding when you are on camera and you were doing a Zoom and you were presenting, what does your backdrop look like? Like, Mai, you've got like your backdrop, but like, does it look professional? You know, do you have a professional background when you are presenting? Are you like in the kitchen with dishes and you've got your messy office, right? That's what we learned about branding, is either having a screen like Mai or making sure that your background looks professional. So that's another tip and trick, especially as you guys grow, especially as you build team, especially as, you know, you want 1,000 people on your team and you're going to be doing talks like me, you know, get your background right.
It can have a huge impact because it can impact people's subconscious mind. They don't even realize what's happening. So take a look at that. And the easiest thing is to do what Mai is doing, right? Is just to put something on there, one of those fake backgrounds for now, or change your chair angle when you're sitting in your office for different Zooms. Like depending on who I'm talking to, yeah, you can see my open closet because I don't have doors yet. If I'm doing a presentation per se, I sit around on the other side of my bed. Don't tell anyone, but that's my desk right now. And I swing around. So you just see this wood background. So you can just move slightly where you are. And I just wanted to refer to Mai's comment here in the comments. I just thought it was so great that she says about being nervous is since diving more into social media and letting go of being perfect and doing more, the ease and the shoulds and being me has become easier. So you just got to go with this stuff and it may feel weird at first, but then just because it's different, but then when you really tune into what is true to you, it's going to be so much more natural and the real you will just shine because there's no imposter syndrome going on. You're just being authentically you, talking about what lights you up.
Awesome. So we just finished step 5. We've got 6, 7, 8, 9. So 4 more that we're going to hopefully get through, and we're going to give you homework and we're going to give you partners. So Melissa, behind the scene, as we're going to go for the next exercise, I want you to work on partners. I want you to take a stab at putting partners together so that after this, they can get together and book a time. And then they will be working together on this assignment and giving each other feedback and going through this assignment again and sharing each assignment, each of the exercises with your partner and helping you guys come up together with a clear brand. Isn't that cool? You guys are leading the team in this. So imagine that all of us create that image. We're going to be inspiring the rest of the team to figure this stuff out. And you guys will be able to teach your team how to do this, which is awesome. Okay. So I'm going to keep on going here. You guys are doing great. So we are now heading to step six. This is who do you want to reach? Where can you find them? Who do you want to impact? Identify your specific target audience and then identify where they live. Which platforms do they go to the most, and write this down. And I think, Melissa, I know I'm getting you to do two things at once, but I know that you and I talked earlier, you wanted to talk a little bit more about avatar. You were going to take that out of your custom program and just share a little bit more and add to this. So just hang tight. Melissa's going to pull that up. As you guys know, Melissa teaches and coaches people to be network marketers, and she has a paid program, but she is going to pull some of her little nuggets out of her paid program that she's been sharing on avatar, just to help you guys really narrow it down. Don't give a red too many things at once, or they're going to like smack you up the side of the face like her. She's like, come on, you just told me to do this. Now you want me to do this. I know how her brain is thinking.
Oops. I packed it all up so I didn't lose it. So yeah, I touched on this at the beginning about speaking to, when I say speaking to, I mean presenting to, posting to your specific avatar so that it lands on them, so that they feel like you are talking directly to them, that you completely understand who they are and what their challenges are, and you start building a relationship with them, so then they trust you and know that you have a solution to their problem. Because guys, we are not selling Tower Gardens. We are not selling Juice Plus. We are selling hope to people that what we have is going to be a solution to whatever their problem or pain is. So it's so important you know exactly who you're talking to. So what I always encourage people to do is create your avatar. And I mean really specific. What do they look like? Create an image of them in your mind, or first write it out and picture somebody that looks like that. When I've gone through this, I've actually Googled, so you can find somebody that looks exactly like that. So you have them in your mind every time you were talking to them, or maybe you already know somebody like that. That's a customer. And that is your ideal market. You can think of them every time you are doing a post or doing a live, whatever it might be. So literally, what do they look like? What's their age? What is there a typical body shape or size that you're marketing to specifically? How old are their kids? Are they married? What's their average income? Everything like that. What kind of job might they have? And then go through and think about, what are their pains? Are they bored? Are they looking for community? Are they lost? Are they stressed? Are they not very healthy? Are they desperate for more income, or maybe more fun money? Whatever it is, go through and list all the pains that you can possibly think of. And then, what are they looking for? What might the person be looking for? And an example is, what I might be looking for is community, fun again, versus somebody who has toddlers. They may be looking for more energy. Right? So different. And so that's why it's so important you find out, or you figure out who it is you're talking to, because how you would talk to me is going to be very different than how you're going to talk to a mom of young kids, right? A mom of young kids, and not all, but mostly, is not thinking about traveling or starting a new business. Even though we know this could be amazing for them, that's probably not top of mind because they just don't know what they don't know, right? Whereas someone like me, I might be thinking about that because I'm not worried about kids anymore and I'm done with their stuff. And now it's like, okay, what am I going to do now? So it's very different. So it's so important to figure out, who do you want to market to? And then how can you help them? What do you have to offer that can help that person? We've got all our products. Yes. What are the benefits of those products that can help them? Right? So for the young mom, it's the energy. So you could talk about smoothies, right? It's a quick, easy, healthy meal. So they don't have to spend much time. It doesn't take a whole lot of effort or thought to make a smoothie, right? For me, you're probably talking to me about community, about the business side of things, to have more money to do stuff like that. What else do you have to offer? We've got resources. We have, like, honestly, we have everything wrapped into one. But is there other stuff that you do that you could help them as well? If you're a nutritionist, can you be doing meal plans for them? If you're an energy healer, can you be offering that? Whatever it might be, right? What are all the things outside of Juice Plus and Tower Gardens that you can also offer? And then the other thing I like to suggest to people is be a resource. So I don't do, let me think of an example. Like if people need specific nutrition help, I am quite happy to refer them on to a different nutritionist, to a naturopath, or to recommend a product that I like. Because that's actually going to build more trust. If you are being a resource for other people, they're going to trust you because you're not just talking about your products, right? You can be sharing your favorite sunscreen right now with what's going on, how to make your sunscreen. Great bathing suits. I know there's a couple of my kids' friends that have bathing suit companies. So recommending that, whatever it might be, but just recommending your favorite things. Like Kelly Morgan does a brilliant job of that. Her favorite pots and pans, her favorite this product at Costco, and on it goes. So just becoming this amazing resource for people. So they're like, oh, you know what? I bet Janice would know something about XYZ. And reach out to her, right? She's very much into energy and all different kinds of healing modalities. So she's somebody I would think of first if somebody was looking for stuff like that.
Awesome.
And then
one
other part on that. Then think of the opposite. What is that person going to miss out on if they don't get involved with you, join your team, or buy your product? So how is their life going to be missing something?
Awesome. Thank you. Yeah. So we've only got about 20 minutes. So I'm going to keep on going because I think that Melissa did a really great dive and you guys are going to have to do some homework. So she's going to work on the breakout. So who do you want to reach? Where can you find them? Okay. Who do you want to impact? So I think a lot of you guys know, example for myself would be, who do I want to impact? I want to impact the woman that's feeling a little bit lost. I want to impact the woman that's, you know, fighting aging. I want to work with the woman, you know, that is, the grays are coming in, the wrinkles are coming in, the extra weight are coming in. They're starting to get frustrated. They don't know where to turn. They're looking for somebody to lift them up and offer them hope. You know, I'm really clear, especially with my Gorgeous Gray movement, exactly who I want to be working with. I know what she looks like. I interview her. I share her story, right? It's kind of like my avatar is what I connect with on a daily basis. And then it's so much easier than to post content and do my TikToks because I know who I'm talking to. Does that make sense? Okay, so who do you want to reach? So that is step six. We're going to keep on going because we're running out of time here. I want you to get through the next three steps. So, and I will give you this document. So step seven is, what platforms will you use to feature yourself? Are these the go-to platforms of your target audience? So this is a place where you will brand yourself out loud, where you will get yourself out there, be in people's faces. These are the places where you live. If you need to do some research, do your due diligence to look up surveys to validate where you think you should go to have the widest reach. And so I'm just going to name some platforms and then you need to decide in what platforms you're going to consistently play in. So obviously there is the Facebook. It tends to be more of an older generation because that was the first platform. But look up the stats for Facebook. A lot of people are still on Facebook, even the younger. Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, Twitter. And you don't have to do them all. I'm not on Twitter. I'm not on Snapchat. You know, my main platforms are definitely Facebook and Instagram. And I'm just starting to play in the realm of TikTok. I don't know, Melissa, anything else on that? That's pretty, you know, the basics to build. LinkedIn, I know you're on LinkedIn. I see that you post. LinkedIn can be another place if your target market is maybe professionals, like for Melissa, right? She's looking for a certain avatar. She plays on LinkedIn. You don't have to play on LinkedIn, but these are what we're talking about. Write down your platforms and maybe pick your top two, top three, and start to get good and consistent on those platforms, showing up with your professional photo, your billboard, your bio, and get those right.
And don't get overwhelmed. Just even if you just start with one, if that's all you can wrap your brain around right now, awesome.
Yeah, and Terry said Pinterest. Yeah, Pinterest too is another platform. Mm-hmm. Okay, great. So that's step seven. Step eight is get into action. So this is a time when you get committed. If it helps, change the music to something that gets you in a state of being driven. Lose yourself. What will you do? What are the steps you need to take the step into becoming a social media legend? Start with three things you can do now and then write them down, what you need to do strategically to get your brand machine in place and go. Okay, so I want to just take a step here. So when I say action, I want to show you, I have this in my PowerPoint right here. Melissa, you can see that screen? You can see my PowerPoint or no? No, it didn't move over. Okay, hold on.
No.
Right here. Okay. So I want you guys to write this down. So in order for you to create a billboard, let's say on the back of Facebook, you can go to a website called, Fiverr.com. It's $10. Fiverr, thank you. Fiverr, $10 US. And they will actually do your billboard for you. They will actually do your billboard for you. They trained on this on GoPro. You just fill it out. You have to give them a professional photo. You got to give them the three things, like the three superpowers that you want. You got to give them your mission statement and kind of like a call to action. Okay, I'm in the middle of a workshop. Oh, that's cute. Oh, God. Okay, you're funny. Okay, go away.
Can you write down the things again that we need to give them?
Yeah, it'll show. So when you go on there, it will tell you exactly what they're looking for. So you'll need a professional photo, and you want your photo in your billboard to be different than your professional photo in your profile picture. So you kind of want to have two different images. Or you can go to Canva and you can look up Facebook covers and you can do it yourself for free. So you have an option. I actually used Canva myself. It took me a long time though. I would say I probably spent way too much time on it. For $10 US, I'd rather have somebody else do it. And this is why colors are so important, because they do ask, what are your colors? What is your brand? What is your colors? What do you want me to put in it? And then they will come back and give you some options. And a lot of the professionals will maybe change it even once a month. If you're promoting something, if you're promoting a shred, you could change it. If you're promoting the 31 days of healthy snacks, you could see over time that you could maybe over an entire year have 12 different billboards. If you are promoting a program, if you're promoting a new cookbook, if you're promoting a new whatever, you could get this company to make you these different billboards through the year. Okay, does that make sense? Beautiful. Okay, so I'm going to stop sharing there. I'm going to go back to sharing with you guys what, where is it? There it is. Okay, so getting into action. I want you guys to just write down some things that you want to start to do from this workshop. So what are the three things that you're going to start to do? So I would say, what are the platforms that you're going to focus on would probably be the first question, and circle them. Your profile picture would be an action. Make sure that you get your profile picture up and professional. I would say a third one would be to get your billboard up and running. and learning how, like, you know, one of the exercises that Melissa does in her course is asking your five good friends what they think your superpower is. So if you're kind of stuck on, oh my gosh, I don't know what my three things are, ask your five good circle people. You could also put that on your social media feed as a question. What do you think my top three superpowers are? And see a common thing of how people already see you. And that might help if you feel stuck. So getting into action is going to be really important for you guys to make that happen. Okay. And then step nine is your bio and your picture. Now that you're clear on who you are, your brand, how you're going to convey yourself online, it's time to create a bio. It should be succinct. Let people know who you are and what you do, and then decide on what your image will be, what picture you will use. It may be different depending on the platform. For example, for LinkedIn, you might want to have a headshot that is more professional. For your Facebook page, you might want a picture of you speaking on stage or doing something athletic if that is your business. Just remember, your cover photo reflects your brand. So take a few minutes now to write your bio and jot down the images you will use. So this is how we will close off. We've got about 12 minutes. I'm going to give you about 7 minutes to start playing with your bio. I will show you my bio. Again, just as an example, I will go into Facebook for you guys so that you can see. You guys can see that. Okay, so my bio is pretty simple. Inspiring women to become the best version of themselves. And then I have a follow me. And the follow me is really important because that's the call to action. That's what they taught us on the platform of social media is like, follow me. And then I have a website, but for a lot of you, you don't have a website, is you put your link tree there. So your link tree is like your website. So instead of going out and investing in you thinking you have to have a website, no, you do not have to have a website. That's where you're going to put your link tree. So that's what you guys are going to work on right now for the next 7 or 8 minutes is get your bio. Start with your bio. So this is what it's going to be. It's just going to be a power statement. Okay. Let me pull up. Let's see if Fraser has his. This changes all the time. Here you go. This is Fraser's. Fraser always changes his background based on what's coming up. So he's obviously got some type of a challenge, but he's always, yellow is his color. He uses yellow a lot. And this was his bio. On a mission to help network marketers set their business on fire using social media. So I have a little bit of a script and a formula that they gave us to doing your bio. So let me just grab it for you. Do you have time? Can you type that into the chat? I'll read it out loud, Melissa. So your bio, so helping blank to blank. So it'd be helping women to make more money. So helping blank to blank could be one kind of script for your bio. Another one would be, on a mission to help blank to blank. You can see Fraser on a mission to help network marketers, right? To do what? To set their business on fire. So he uses that formula. On a mission to what? To help network marketers set their business to what? To set their businesses on fire. So you got two templates there that you guys can use for your bio, okay? I'll let you guys go. I'll put some music on. Come back here in about 6 or 7 minutes.
best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke. Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. Are you ever gonna know if you never even try? Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name. Politicians be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders. Be astronauts, be champions. Be truth seekers. Be students, be teachers. Be politicians, be preachers, preachers. Be believers, be leaders. Be astronauts, be champions.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Okay, I wish I could give you guys more time. You can see that Melissa and I hung out for 16 hours doing this type of stuff. So we can't do 2 hours justice. This isn't something that's gonna open overnight, but we gave you a little teaser about what we were able to do. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm wondering if there is anybody that got to a place where you feel like you got a little bit of a statement or a bio that you wanna share. Renee's shaking her. Okay, good. Yep, go for it.
So I had a bio already on my profile, so I just kind of added to it. I said, I'm a food scientist. I work with food in a whole different way. Now I use expertise to bring the science of food, health, and wellness home on a mission to help families to make their lives easier.
So you went from that long, long bio and you just went to the very end, which is really short and sweet. Is that what you're just shed? You're
yeah, trying- so I had... the longer bio
okay,
already
got it.
Up there and I added the on a mission to help families make life easier.
Life easier. So, okay. So on a mission to help, but I don't know exactly what that means when you say life easier. So you might need to be a little bit more specific with the niching down. So there's going to be your opportunity. So life is so general, like life to me is like, is that food? Is that sex? Is that like, what is that? It's just way out there. Right. So it's like me saying, I'm a nutritionist. Okay, great. And what do you do? So I even had to get clear to say, okay, I got to focus on helping women get more energy because that's how I came into the Juice Plus business is Juice Plus gave me my energy back, my mama mojo back. So I want to be able to pass the baton to another tired mama bear Do you see what I mean? Mm-hmm. So, but good. It's a great start. And thank you. Do you guys see the difference of what her before was? Before was very long. I'm a food scientist. I did right, like long. So we're trying to help you get really narrow and focused and clear. So that's awesome. Thanks for the first round. That's awesome. Good job. Lori says, on a mission to help empower women to take control of their nutritional, physical, and emotional health. Okay. So again, you're getting down to that. You might end up wanting to even get narrow, but that is a great start. Okay, no problem, Irene, you got a mic, go, no problem. Anybody else wanna share what you feel like you're, yeah, mom?
Said inspiring people to rethink aging and healthy lifestyle.
Ooh, love it. Mm-hmm. And I could see you branding yourself in the purple and like healthy granny, like shortening it up to know, like, you know, I think granny came to me today, like you're the coolest grandma in town, right? Like, if your target market is other like grannies that are lost their mojo, don't have the energy. Like, I'm just like, I would love to sit down with you and just like, you know, you're going to be the go-to. It's like, oh my God, my mom is having so much trouble. Like she's gone gray. She's complaining about her knees. She's doing this. And they think of you. Oh my gosh, you got to follow Janice. Are you kidding me? You'll totally relate to her. She's funny. She's happy. She's joyful. She's teaching you how to make, you know, healthy food in the kitchen. You know, she's 67. I just had this image, you know, what one of your goals that you could put on Insta. My goal is to live beyond 100. Like telling people what your goal is, right? Living healthy beyond 100. Like, bam, like this woman, like everything that she does is about like aging, pro-aging health. Yeah, and suggesting narrowing it down with women, used retired or midlife, menopausal, young, et cetera. Exactly. Even just what I learned, I have a program called Clean It Up. I realized that, what does it even mean? So I'm like, I got to get specific. I got to put a word in front of clean it up. So it's menopausal clean it up or hormone clean it up. So it's specific. Brandy, I saw your hand go up. Do you want to share?
I wrote down igniting women to create a life of vision, empowering financial independence, and inspiring health.
Very good. It's a start, right? It's a start. But Melissa, you're going to say something?
Just what I said, niche down. When we say women, specifically, Brandy, do you want to work with somebody that's like seniors, or do you want to work with 19-year-olds, or you want to work with women your age? Like, find a word to describe the group that you want to work with.
I don't know how to describe the age.
Or maybe a
30 to 47. And I don't resonate with young moms or, you know, moms with kids. And I don't really care about kids that much.
I hear you. I totally get you. So what is the pain of that mom? Burned out moms?
Good
Something
one.
Like that. Lonely moms, single moms, unfulfilled. Like, what is the pain of that, of these women that so many people are choosing? Right? Are they like retired, menopausal, hormonal,
grumpy,
bored? Yeah, of course. Maybe that could be. Who am I to say? But something
I wasn't
like
saying that was you.
Find an adjective that describes the pain of those women, and that's who you're helping.
Oh, I like that. I like the burnt out moms. That's a good one. Like, instead of saying I help women increase energy, like you could say, like, you know, I help burnt out mommies raise their energy.
My Instagram profile says, to the woman who feels lost, I give you permission to take permission to, oh, I lost it. Permission to want more and take control of your life.
That's not saying what you do, but though.
So that's why I'm trying to change it, but I don't, there's not enough words.
You could just switch it to, I help lost women, and then whatever the rest of it was that you said.
I know, but that's not even, I don't feel like that's it.
That's okay. That's a first draft. Now you know what you don't want.
Right.
Oh, listen, Melissa, you should have seen how much work Melissa and I have had to work on hers. We were going one direction, then we were over here, then we're over here. Like, it's not easy. This is not easy work, guys. This is, it's going to take you a while to tweak it. But you guys, I think, are getting to understand how you're getting to niche down, right? How you're getting to get there. We're giving you a formulation, and now you guys just have to do the work and play. I need help with this for sure.
12th draft at least. So don't even go look at mine, because it's not good. And it's not a good example right now. I'm still struggling big time with mine.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So yeah, definitely help. So here's what, do you have partners? Have you suggested partners?
Yep. And if you guys scroll up in the chat, I put them all there.
Okay, I'm trying to scroll up here so I can
see. I can read them out if you want. Does that help?
Okay, yeah.
I've got Janice Mai, Lori and Jen F, Teresa and Renee, Sherry, Alona and Jennifer, Brandy and Irene, Melissa and Shelly, Angela and Stacy.
Okay, you guys write down your partner name, make sure you connect with them. So your goal would be in the next, I would say, week to go through this assignment with them, just like you've written everything down, and then let them know where you're at on your bio and let them give you feedback. And Melissa and I are here to help. So definitely reach out to us privately so that you can give us your shitty first, second, third draft, and we can give you feedback on it, okay? So just send it to us. This is what we're thinking. I would definitely tap in. I'm going to definitely use that website and see what they come up with so that I can see and get some help with my billboard, because I want help with my billboard. But all we want to do is start to really, you know, get you thinking about niching down. And I hope that this was a first start. Obviously we could use another 2 more hours to do some more, you know, work and some brainstorming, but this is a start. We have another workshop in a month, next month on this. So you guys kind of have a month to get this set up so that you're ready for the next, because this is your foundation. You got to get this right before we can move you on to doing TikToks and doing reels and all that stuff. You don't want to be going there until you figure out who you are and your brand. Yeah, I know, Terry, you're having trouble with your Linktree. I saw that. I went on to see and I went click. We'll have to look and see what's going on there. Hey. Okay. So I think that's it. That's all. It's 104. Thank you so much for your time and trusting us to share some basics on social media. I think what I'll do with the PDF is I will put it in Team B under the units tab under files, so that you guys can just go there anytime and grab it and use it as a tool. It's module 2, and that's what you will go hunting for. Module 2 out of a module 7. I think there's 7 modules, but it's module 2 that you can go grab that. So I will do that sometime today to download it for you guys. Melissa, any closing words?
No, just if you have time right now, keep working with this right now, because your mindset is focused on this, your creative juices are flowing, and you're just kind of in the right mindset. Keep working on it. And then message your partner right now to set up a time to do this. And just keep your notes that you have today on your desk or handy so that you can, oh, when something comes up, write it down. Because every single day I think, oh, that's a great idea for a TikTok. I will totally remember that. That's awesome. The next morning, what was that idea? I totally forget. So write the ideas down as they come to you, because then you can expand on them later on, good, bad, or otherwise. Oh, this word or anything at all. So.
Absolutely. And Mom, when you go on to, if you're going to do TikTok, you can start to find some women that are absolute, like they're grannies. They're actually grannies on TikTok. And they make me laugh so hard. They are so funny. They are just killing it. They are dancing. They are showing their health and vitality, and they make you laugh. It's like they pretend they're like an old granny, like with a cane, and then they kind of do a boom, 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 and then they're just strutting their stuff. Like,
I would be perfect for you, Janice.
Right? Oh yeah. Pretending like, you know, you're 67 and barely can walk, and then do a bam, 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 and like show them your hot, sexy body with your purple bling.
Yeah. Oh, what, this is what most people think 60-year-olds are like. And you can do a few photos of, you know, eating slop and just, you know, blah, blah, blah. And then, but this is what 60 could be like. And then, all the flash, like all the photos of you in Mexico and all the stuff that you do. So,
yeah, on your bike, in your canoe, climbing a mountain, right? Doing your planks, doing your Qigong, giving people hope. Awesome, guys. Okay, I will wrap up. I got a 1:15. Thanks so much for joining. And
Thank you. And
we'll drop this again. We'll let you know where we're going to drop this recording. Thanks, guys. Have a good afternoon.
Thanks. Melissa and Nicole and all.
Thank you.
Great job.